Deborah! Deborah! Can you hear me?
Helena?
Thank goodness.
Deborah Harper is perhaps one of the most sympathetic characters that we come to know during the events of the game Resident Evil 6. Sister to the main character Helena Harper, Deborah was dragged into this predicament simply for her connections to Helena. Kidnapped by Derek Simmons and the family, only to be used as a bargaining chip to force Helena's compliance in their plans.
Look at me! Look at me! It's gonna be okay! Just keep your eyes on me.
Help me!
I'm gonna get you out of here, Deborah. Deborah, look at me.
Deborah Harper was born on October 10th, 1992, and was 4 years younger than her older sister, Helena. Being 20 before her kidnapping, Deborah was still attending college, and unlike her sister, who was generally a fairly aggressive individual, Deborah was something of a carefree party girl. The girls' two different approaches to life caused more than a few conflicts between them. However, after the deaths of their parents, they grew closer as a result of the other being the only family that they had left. This bond, however, would unfortunately be their downfall. Being the carefree-spirited girl that she was, Deborah had gotten herself into an abusive relationship. The man that she was with had beat her badly one night during a breakup, and Helena couldn't sit idly by and watch. Helena shot Deborah's boyfriend, giving him serious injuries, and in doing so, sent the sisters on a direct course to be used as pawns in Derek Simmons' plans. For a while, life continued on as usual for the sisters. Deborah was still in college, and as a result of the shooting of Deborah's boyfriend, Helena was demoted to be in the Secret Service. This new position made Helena the perfect candidate for Simmons' plans to assassinate the president, and all he needed was her sister, Deborah. You see, with the shooting that had gotten her demoted, Helena had proven that she would do anything for her sister. Which meant that, if she was taken, Helena would have no choice but to comply with Simmons' commands. And so, 3 days before the eventual death of the president, the two sisters were abducted by Simmons.
It's all my fault. I did this.
What are you talking about?
Deborah was used as a bargaining chip to get Helena to call the Secret Service into a scramble by reporting that assassins were infiltrating the college campus on which the president was supposed to be speaking. But while Helena was out doing Simmons' bidding, Deborah was being held in the research lab underneath the Tolos Cathedral. The initial plan given by Simmons was to kill the girl once Helena had left. However, other members of Simmons' group, known as the Family, thought that she would be better used in a different way. So Deborah was kept around to be used as a test subject for the experimental C-virus. Once she was injected, however, her body showed no outward signs of transformation, although Deborah could feel the virus eroding her mind from within. Eventually, the researchers and members of the Family were forced to evacuate before the quarantine of Tall Oaks set in, leaving Deborah on the lower levels of the research laboratory. And this is where she would eventually be found by her sister and her sister's backup, Leon Kennedy. Helena attempted to rescue her younger sister, but to no avail. And as they made their way further down the path, the C-virus finally took control. Deborah transformed into a chrysalid before their very eyes, and once she emerged, she was no longer the carefree party girl that she once was. Reduced to a beast with the face of her sister, Helena was forced to fight the woman that she'd tried so hard to save. And with the backdrop of the Simmons family catacombs, Helena would see the last remaining member of her family, lost to a man who saw them as no more than pawns in some grand game.
No more tears. Not until I avenge your death. Please. Forgive me.